LJ-287's primary supermassive black hole weighs in at 18 billion solar masses. And the black hole in galaxy NGC 4889 weighs 21 billion solar masses. That's over 5,000 times larger than Sagittarius A star.
These are incredible things that are more massive than some galaxies.
And there could be even bigger black holes out there, a mind-blowing 30 billion times the mass of the sun. Incredibly, all these overgrown black holes are a complete mystery because we have no idea how they got so big.
It's a huge mystery how black holes have become so enormous. We started finding black holes with millions and billions of times the sun's mass. No one expected that, and we have no idea how they got to be so big.
It may seem unimportant to know how black holes grow, but we are discovering that black holes play an important role in the universe and our place in it.
Your existence, the existence of the sun and the earth, are intimately tied to the existence of the 4 million solar mass black hole at the center of our Milky Way galaxy.
There is no way we'll ever be able to understand how a galaxy works until we understand how the supermassive black holes work. So the story of our origins, where did we come from, how did we form, it will have to start with the supermassive black holes.
February 2015. Astronomers report something unusual in the galaxy NGC 2276. It looked like something had taken a bite out of one of its spiral arms. Sitting alone in the void was an intermediate mass black hole, about 50,000 times the mass of the sun. It looked like the black hole had eaten its neighborhood clean. But the detection of a burst of energy from the black hole suggests a curious possibility. The black hole may have burped so hard, it blasted away its food. If a black hole tries to swallow more than it can chew, it can choke.
Imagine a giant traffic jam in a one-way street. So all this stuff is trying to come in, and in the center, toward the black hole, it's moving really, really, really fast. And so that keeps it from falling in directly because it's orbiting so quickly. So the material coming in from behind wants to get in also, but it's blocked. And so you have a traffic jam at the event horizon of this black hole.
As the traffic jam grows, the disk gets even hotter. So hot, the matter changes state and transforms into a treacly plasma. The treacly plasma can't spin around the black hole, and the whole system explodes. All the food in the accretion disk is blown outwards.
These beams can actually be incredibly violent. Matter is flung out at a large fraction of the speed of light. It's a tremendous wind that blows very hard away from the black hole.
The jet hits the gas clouds surrounding the black hole, blowing the food away.
If they eat too much, they can basically blow everything that's in their vicinity away. They lose their food supply, and then they're going to starve. They can kind of shoot themselves in the foot.
With no food available, the black hole stops growing. Astronomers think that's what happened to the intermediate black hole they discovered floating in the dead zone. These messy-eating habits may stop the black holes growing, but we now understand that this process is important for a galaxy's health and stability.
It's the fact that they're messy eaters that makes them so important. It's all the stuff that gets shot out that regulates galaxy formation. So this whole process, while it's messy, it's important and fundamental.
As black holes eat stuff and get bigger, they donate some of that material to the environment by their incredible jets. They burp out that material, and some of that material will inevitably form the next generation of stars.
These burps may regulate star formation and stop the black hole from getting obese. But over time, the black hole will start eating again as gas falls back towards it. But can it eat enough to become supermassive?
Could that black hole have become so obese by eating?
There are these supermassive black holes that exist in the very early universe, and by all accounts, they should not exist.
According to the normal laws of physics, they can't have grown so big so quickly.
For astrophysicists, understanding how black holes have grown to be so large is one of our biggest mysteries.
We need some other way of growing these supermassive black holes. There needs to be some other mechanism that allows them to get that massive so early. But what is that?
Everything we see in the night sky makes up just 4.8% of all the matter in the cosmos. The rest is the dark universe, including dark matter. We can't see it, feel it, or detect it directly. But we know dark matter is there, as its gravity is tugging on everything around it.
Most of the stuff that collects together gravitationally is dark matter. So perhaps black holes form somehow with the inclusion of dark matter.
One way of looking at it is there's six times as much dark matter as normal matter. So there's six times as much food out there for the black holes to eat if they're able to tap into this dark stuff.
Maybe these supermassive black holes are growing by eating dark matter.
There are some tantalizing clues. The largest supermassive black holes tend to live in the galaxies with the most dark matter.
Some believe that dark matter sparked early universe superstars. When they die, they leave behind supermassive black holes.
Dark stars sound like science fiction, but Dr. Katie Fries believes they may explain how early supermassive black holes grew so fast.
Dark stars are amazing. So when we first had this idea, we got excited really quickly because this is a new type of star that has never been seen before.
Dark stars may have been some of the very first stars to form when the universe was just 200 million years old. But how could dark stars transform into really massive black holes?
One of the best ideas we have for dark matter is that it's made of weakly interacting massive particles, or WIMPs for short. So these WIMPs are their own antimatter, and that means whenever they encounter each other, they annihilate and turn into something else. That means a lot of heat is released, a lot of energy, and it's that energy that could power stars.
The energy from the WIMP's annihilations keeps the star from collapsing like a normal star.
So it's possible that in some stars, their internal reactions are actually being powered by dark matter. If that's the case, then you can imagine situations where when that burns out, you produce very massive black holes. So it could be that dark matter, the physics of dark matter, plays really important roles in creating black holes and their prevalence in the universe.